Nice.
We actually then were able to go out in the marsh and deploy some of the boards once they were finished.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. So it was really exciting to see.
I think one of the really neat features about this project is it's a space where plastics really may not be necessary, and we are likely, we hope, I guess it's our hypothesis, we're going to have natural material replacements that will be able to do the job, and in so doing we can have a real tangible impact on the environment.
Globe is acting along a distance here.
I'd say it was a calling. I've always wanted to do something where I felt like I was having an impact, felt like I had a chance to make a difference, help people.
He has a genuine care about how you're doing, not only in his class, but as a human being.
3.25 now.
We have a lot of projects going on in the lab.
And so now as we increment this, what do we sort of expect to see?
We look at materials ranging from kind of funky stuff like self-healing elastomers, so think rubber bands and softer materials that can heal if you damage them, kind of like biological tissue, all the way over to additively manufactured metals.
So conductivity is broken between...
Students are vital to my research, essential.
So I think with exposing materials, we probably want to get a couple of samples at Baruch.
This stuff is filthy.
Yeah.
Are we true hands-on work?
One of our current research projects, which is sponsored by NOAA, focuses on natural fiber-based alternatives to plastics that are used in marine environments.
So think like retaining walls or like fishing line or big ones, oyster bags.
And our central research question in this project is can we find natural alternatives to plastics that can survive the harsh conditions of these coastal environments?
So we're gonna try to do some single fiber testing of these natural materials, and then we're gonna take those and subject them to environmental factors. If we can make a product that can be used and replace some of these plastics efficiently, then that's like one less piece of plastic in the ocean.
I mean, this is the first thing you gotta think about when you're doing testing is how do you extract the specimen.
Do you have any wisdom on how long I should make it?
Yeah, that's a good start. Mm-hmm.
People start pretty green, and that's exactly what we expect. They're green, they're gonna make mistakes, and that's what we want, and that's what we expect.
36, exactly.
You see people who emerge from these experiences more confident, more creative, more well-rounded, and really more workforce ready.
I don't know that I'd be able to do what I did here without Dr. Lowe and his impact on me. I worked with him from my sophomore year onward to do my honors thesis, exploring if you can recycle plastic and 3D print it and what effects that has on the mechanics of the material itself. And we would constantly have conversations about not only the project, but what I wanted out of my career and my life and how the work that I was doing now could contribute towards where I was wanting to go.
Helping people look in the mirror and then become their best selves. And learn how to persevere, learn how to struggle, learn how to fight through adversity. That's where I think my gifts are.
He was my research advisor, and he was my mentor, and he was my professor at the same time.
Barry's got tremendous fire in his belly, and when I see somebody with fire in their belly, you want to see him succeed, and you're going to do everything in your power to make sure that happens.
He realized that I was having difficulties in the class, and it was all because that I was working full-time and going to school full-time. So I'll come to school and leave here around like 2:30 p.m. and drive straight to Cincinnati and work over there from 3 to 11 p.m.
He was barely sleeping and coming here and taking like aerospace engineering classes.
He had a meeting with me and he was like, Barry, we need to be able to kind of like get you a job that will be able to help you out with your classes. And I think that is the reason why I was able to graduate. So I'll say he's a man of faith who understands people and looks at the weaknesses in people and tries to bring them up.
He really encouraged me to learn things myself and make sure I really understood what was going on so that I really had a full understanding of what I was working with. So I was really going in with nothing and came out with lots of new knowledge.
Sometime in the spring of 2020, the world kind of came crashing down. Around us with COVID. My research that I'd planned to do with Dr. Lowe seemingly was gonna fall apart. But luckily he actually still worked with me over that summer. In fact, he helped me acquire some funding through NASA. And I actually started working on a system in my barn with my phone, a can of spray paint, and just some samples that I happened to bring home from the lab. And I used that as kind of the foundation for what I later went on to present to NASA for my space grant work. And the results of that research ended up funneling into an honors thesis, many grad school applications, fellowship applications, and it paved the way for my PhD work I'm working on currently.
He is training the next generation of servant leaders in engineering and giving them an example of what it means to not only be a good engineer, but a good person. Faculty like Bob and plenty of others in engineering are so incredible about matching the mission and values of this institution to the work that they're doing.
Would you have expected that?
I didn't really know. I would have thought a more like dramatic, little bit of stretch and then immediate tear.
Yeah.
I think one of the really good qualities about Dr. Lowe being our mentor is we'll ask him a question and his response is, well, what do you think? He really takes what we have to say into consideration.
I think some of our best work has been because he was able to let us get a little bit off the path due to a little trailblazing and then come back, circle back around.
I think the thing I like best about working with students is being some maybe small part of the growth that happens during their time here at UD.
I think it was a big part of my growth. I wouldn't say it was a small part, but again, that speaks volumes to the kind of person he is. He doesn't see the work that he does as being about him. He sees it as being about others and the growth that he can contribute for them, and he expects nothing in return. Yeah, it's who I strive to be as somebody who wants a career as an academic and a mentor to others.